good afternoon to you from Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta. A beautiful early autumn day. Decision day 2022 in Major League Soccer. Unfortunately for Atlanta United, they will not be going to the MLS Cup playoffs in 2022. But that fact has not deterred thousands of Atlanta United supporters from pouring into the stadium one more time to support the home side as they take on New York City FC.
I don't care what the result is today, this is our club, do you hear me? Make it special for us as supporters, make it special for the players on the pitch.
Many reasons, the fans, your families. This team suffered a lot. Este equipo sufrió mucho este año. Injury situations, stupid things that happened, okay? A lot of things, we deserve this. So let's win today, come on.
I think we knew we had some quality on our roster. Just getting to know each other more on and off the field was kind of our expectations.
Começou um ano muito bom, uma viagem muito boa também para o México. Fizemos uma grande pré-temporada. Estávamos todos muito bem preparados.
And then when Thiago came along as well, I think it was an exciting time because we saw how talented he was and what he could bring to the group.
From day one, whether it's preseason or the day a new individual walks through the door to join this club, the expectation is to compete for trophies. The expectation is to be top, to be, you know, if not top, then in and around the top to be competing.
You know, I think even for some of the coaching staff, it was probably the same way. They came in halfway through last year. So to develop that type of relationship where we're all in a hotel for a couple weeks at a time, spending almost every single hour of the day, I think it's a really good chance for us to come together as a group, and I think that's what we did.
3-1 Atlanta United over Sporting Kansas City on a day where the kids were all right.
Oh, it was so good. I can't even describe that feeling because for me, I really wanted to come into preseason fit, determined, and persistent to kind of, you know, make a year and a name for myself here at Atlanta. So starting in that first game, I was just buzzing, all the energy from the crowd, because I know they had high expectations for us as well.
We were very optimistic at the beginning of the year. You look at the roster that we had and the quality of players on that roster. You know, you just look at the names on the list and our team can beat anyone in the league at any given moment. So.
Definitely any win is great, especially the first one of the season at home. But I think it was something we expected out of, our team. Early that game, you know, Luis scores, but he comes off with a hamstring injury, so that was definitely tough for us.
Yeah, I think we were, starting to find cohesion, starting to understand, and you start to gain momentum, especially early on with results like that, and then tragedy struck, and injury after injury after injury.
Brad Guzan really struggling here, coming off his line, not a good sight. Guzan in agony.
I'm like, Like, if you get the, like, footage, I'm like, nah. Like, I thought he was joking at first, but then I'm like, nah, because I knew right away that that's what happened because Dylan did it, you know, 2 weeks prior to that. So now I'm like, nah, no way. Like, because he's that guy. He's that core. He's that leader, especially defensively. And right away, knowing he's going to be out the whole entire season, I'm like, we just started. This sucks, you know.
You know, he leads by example, but he also always says the right things before games, during games, after games. And to lose that sort of mental leader for us, that was a big blow as well.
Ronaldo came in and he's a very humble, soft-spoken guy. On the field, it's different. He really works for the team. He puts others before himself. And he'll run for the guy, and I think that's one thing about Ronaldo that you can always expect to get from him is that he will work for you.
Es muy bonito siempre anotar un gol, pero anotar tres en un mismo partido es algo especial, es algo inolvidable. Cuando va cayendo el primero, pues buscas el segundo, y cuando cae el segundo buscas el tercero, y cuando cae el tercero buscas el cuarto. Siempre es así. Para el equipo, para un delantero, para cualquier jugador. Y bueno, ese partido fue algo muy especial que se me dio los tres goles.
Miles Robinson, the captain of Atlanta United down. It doesn't look good at all. I mean, the way he's reacting right now, pounding the ground.
You know, I think Miles is one of those guys that he doesn't say much, but he's, you know, the best center back in the league. And whenever he's on the field, you just get that extra confidence boost of talent that you have.
Miles es un gran jugador. Fue una pérdida muy dolorosa para el equipo. Creo que siempre ese tipo de situaciones, a pesar de una victoria, tú sientes una derrota dentro del equipo, una pérdida.
Whenever we found out it was the Achilles injury, I was just heartbroken just because, I mean, one, very good friend of mine, and two, knowing that he would miss the World Cup in Qatar, and that's something that he was such an important factor bringing the team to that position, you know? So I think that's the one that kind of hurt me the most.
You know, it's unprecedented in terms of three Achilles in 2 weeks or 3 weeks. Ozzy's injury was massive, and then, you know, I think there was another 3-4 week spell where every week there was somebody else with maybe not a long term, but long enough to create some issues in terms of selection wise. But you want to say that those things happen in sports and you have to be able to deal with them. I don't know if they happen in the level that they happened to us this year.
Just to get carted off is a psychological blow that like really kind of stinks. And it's definitely frustrating because you know, you become so close to these guys because you pretty much see them every day. They're like your brothers, you know, and you want to, you know, help your brothers, you know what I'm saying? And when you can't, it feels like you're like worthless at times, which kind of sucks, especially because your whole life you've created your whole persona around playing a sport that you can't play, so it's tough.
This is the halfway point of the season for Atlanta United. 17 matches in the room.
There were some moments in, you know, you're watching games at home when they're on the road, you're watching games in the stadium, and you're losing your mind. Going about the results, you know, how we played, there were flashes of brilliance and then just crazy plays, you know, that you're thinking, you know, leaves you scratching your head. What are we doing in those moments?
Creo que el equipo estaba pasando por altibajos, y la verdad que fue doloroso entrar en un 3-0 siendo defensor es duro, es duro, y más en casa, frente a tus fans, frente a tu gente.
Eu creio que para nós jogadores profissionais, qualquer derrota é muito decepcionante. Não importa o resultado, ser 1-0, ser 2-0. Todas as derrotas é muito decepcionante. Sempre fica muito. A gente fica muito triste perder. Trabalhando todos os dias para ser vitorioso. Mas o Walsh também é uma grande equipe.
Afortunadamente, o seguinte partido em casa lo ganamos. E creio que de aí o equipo começou um pouquinho a encontrarse un poco mejor, a entenderse dentro y fuera de la cancha. Al final me parece que en los últimos partidos creo que nos entendimos mucho mejor.
As soon as I came back, I was, you know, chomping at the bit to play and get back in the team and show the guys that we can still make the playoffs, although we weren't in the best situation in the table. As soon as me and Andrew kind of came back into the side, I thought it lifted the spirits of the team and kind of the belief. I wouldn't say the belief was ever lost throughout the season, but it just helps when you get kind of important guys coming back from injury. And Josef, for example, like we had him out a lot at the beginning of the season, and you know, having him come back and score important goals for us at certain moments was it's just makes the group feel more confident and feel like we have more firepower.
You know, and then Juanjo coming in, you know, I knew nothing about him. You know, when it was released, I read a little bit about his career, and it seemed like he was struggling to break through to a team. You know, so for him to come in here and, you know, score the goals that he did, provide big moments for us, but also be solid defensively. I think, you know, he was another guy that the club called upon, and he took his chance. And, you know, now I think he's established in the MLS, and, you know, I think he has a great career ahead of him.
Andrew Gutman, the hero, as Atlanta United at the death steals a 2-1 win against Seattle. The first time they've ever beaten the Sounders.
Recuerdo que Gonzalo me había dicho que si íbamos ganando y tenía chance de meterme, me metía por ahí 10 minutos y terminé jugando como 20 minutos. Y ese día hizo el gol Andrew al último minuto. Y lo que más recuerdo fue el momento donde todos nos fuimos a abrazar y caímos encima de todos. Y que la hinchada fue una cosa loca.
Yeah, that was a special moment for me for sure. You know, I was still struggling a little bit with my injury. I think I only played 9 minutes. And I talked to Gonzo and the staff, and I said, look, I'm ready to go, whatever you need me, 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 60 minutes, whatever, I'll do it. Yeah, so my mentality was just close out the game, you know, get a feel for the game again, so then, you know, next week I can have a bigger impact. I remember I see one opportunity to kind of creep forward into the attacking half, and Marcelino dragged two guys with them, and he just played a square ball to me. And I remember Edwin made like a little run, and it kind of made the midfielder hold a little bit. So it created this pocket for me, and I kind of just took the touch, it bounced up perfect for me, and I just hit it perfectly, and the rest was kind of a blur. I remember just running over, and then I'm on the bottom of the dog pile, and I look over and I see Dom right next to me just laughing at the bottom of the dog pile. So yeah, that was a cool moment for me, but I also think for the club and for the stadium as a whole.
Sim, creio que todos nós estávamos muito bem pro fim da temporada agora. Começamos a ganhar jogos importantes, ganhamos do Orlando fora também, que foi um grande jogo. Creio que a equipe foi se fortalecendo, foi se entrosando ainda mais.
I thought at that point when we went back-to-back wins, we started to get momentum. We had the guys, you know, a lot of guys back from injury, so we had most of a full squad besides the guys that were out for the year. And we started to pick up momentum, and we really had that belief that we were going to be able to make the playoffs.
Siempre estuvimos convencidos y siempre quisimos, ¿no? Obviamente el ganar, todos queremos ganar siempre. Pero aún así, cuando sufríamos derrotas, el equipo, el partido siguiente, estaba convencido de que podíamos ganar también.
Atlanta United stuck to their convictions. They dominated Philadelphia, who's been the best team in the league this season, but they couldn't quite get that final product.
Futbolísticamente fue uno de los mejores partidos que el equipo tuvo. Un gran partido en muchos sentidos, en lo defensivo, en lo ofensivo. Generamos oportunidades ante el mejor equipo de la liga en ese momento.
So I would say Philly was such a great game for us into understanding what we're able to do and why we should do it frequently and more consistently.
Nosotros veníamos de perder contra ellos de visitantes una dolorosa derrota y sabíamos que iba a ser complicado. Juegan muy bien, sinceramente tienen buenos jugadores, pero nosotros sabíamos que podíamos ganarles porque sabemos la calidad de jugadores que tenemos.
Pero bueno, después del empate local contra Filadelfia, que hicimos un gran partido en el cual ellos no nos patearon al arco y nosotros dominamos todo el partido, después de ese partido ya las chances de los playoffs se habían ido, obviamente. Pero bueno, antes de eso obviamente tuvimos la esperanza de seguir ganando porque estábamos en un buen camino, estábamos jugando muy bien al fútbol, que uno cuando juega muy bien generalmente gana, pero bueno, no se dieron como queríamos las cosas.
I think that happened a lot to us this season, not only the Philadelphia game. Yes, that was probably our best performance all year, just the way that we played, the way that we outplayed the best team in the East this season. We played them off the park and we didn't get a result. But yeah, it was just unfortunate that we fell short.
Había veces que jugábamos muy bien y no ganábamos. Entonces creo que la suerte también corre un poquito del lado de los equipos que la buscan, ¿no? Y pienso que bueno, que la suerte no estuvo un poco de nuestro lado en este torneo.
On a disappointing note for Atlanta United. Atlanta United goes into the offseason on a two-match losing streak.
A pesar de no pelear por nada, si no importaba el resultado, había mucha gente apoyándonos, había mucha gente con mucho entusiasmo. Eso tuvo un impacto para mí muy positivo porque creo que eso en México o en otras ligas de Sudamérica no pasa, ¿no?
You know, a lot of people can say, oh, well, the game doesn't matter, you know, the season's over anyway, but, you know, you still have an opportunity to put on the Atlanta United jersey that, you know, millions of people want to put on. You know, you look at the fan base, you look at what Atlanta United means just as a brand, as a soccer club, everything. And,
obviamente, creo que la sensación es de todos la misma, de desilusión, de tristeza. Que no se pudo lograr el objetivo porque, obviamente, en mi opinión, este club es el más grande o de los más grandes de la liga. Y al no cumplir el objetivo que era hacer los playoffs, creo que fue algo muy, muy feo para todos.
Quiero pelear por cosas importantes con este club. Espero también que el equipo esté en el nivel que se espera de este equipo y de este club. Y creo que este equipo está para muy buenas cosas. Creo que este equipo es capaz de ser campeón de la MLS.
The story behind this season is to never give up, you know, understand that success, you know, comes through hard work and determination. And if you stick together as a club, as a group, you know, the fans stick with us, you know, this will turn around and it will be successful because we have the firepower behind us to win, you know, big trophies.
When you put that shirt on, when you put the jersey on and you are wearing the badge of Atlanta United, it has to mean something. It has to mean everything. you know, it's easy to say, right? We want to get back to competing for championships, competing for trophies, but it's a long process, and it's not something that comes overnight. You hear people talk about on the outside, oh, Atlanta United of 2018, 2019, that's a long time ago. And we need to establish the Atlanta United of 2023. Thank you.